The movie starts with us being reintroduced to Lydia Dietz, now a paranormal investigator and host of the show Ghost House. She continues to be haunted by the mischievous Beetlejuice. During one of her episodes, Lydia spots Beetlejuice in the audience, which leaves her shaken. She talks to her boyfriend and manager, Rory, who tries to calm her down by throwing away her medication, although she insists in taking a couple of pills. Soon after, Lydia is bombarded by frantic calls from her stepmother, Delia, who informs her of the devastating news. Her father, Charles, has died in a plane crash and was then eaten by a shark. The two women make plans to return to Winter River for the funeral. Meanwhile, in the afterlife, Beetlejuice works in a department alongside the other shrunken head ghosts. The janitor accidentally revives Dolores, Beetlejuice's former wife, who reassembles herself and begins searching for him, sucking out souls along the way. Beetlejuice is warned about Dolores by Wolf Jackson, the ghost detective, and he realizes that she is out for revenge after he killed her for poisoning him. Back in the living world, Lydia and Delia visit Astrid, Lydia's teenage daughter, at her school. The two share a tense relationship as Astrid resents her mother for being more involved with ghosts than with her. When Delia dramatically announces Charles's death to Astrid, emotions flare. Astrid also expresses anger over the lack of closure about her father's death, deepening her rift with Lydia. As the family returns to Winter River for the funeral, Rory publicly proposes to Lydia, despite her hesitation. Astrid, already annoyed with Rory, leaves in frustration and meets a boy named Jeremy Fraser after crashing a bike near his treehouse. They bond, and later Astrid finds a model of the town and a pamphlet about Beetlejuice in the attic, nearly summoning him. Lydia stops her in time, but Rory later unwittingly says Beetlejuice's name 3 times, trapping both him and Lydia in the model town, where Beetlejuice terrorizes them briefly before Lydia sends them back. On Halloween, Astrid and Jeremy plan to hang out, and Astrid later discovers that Jeremy is a ghost. He persuades her to help him return to the afterlife by promising she can see her father again. Lydia, meanwhile, learns that Jeremy was a murderer and rushes to save Astrid. Unfortunately, Astrid has already entered the afterlife with Jeremy. Desperate, Lydia summons Beetlejuice, agreeing to marry him in exchange for his help in rescuing her daughter. In the afterlife, Astrid is tricked into almost giving up her soul, but her deceased father, Richard, intervenes. Together, Lydia and Richard rescue Astrid from the soul train and the deadly sandworm. Meanwhile, Dolores continues her rampage in the afterlife, killing ghosts in her search for Beetlejuice. Beetlejuice helps Lydia and Astrid confront Jeremy, who is ultimately sent to a hellish landscape through a trap door. Meanwhile, Delia dies after being bitten by venomous asps during one of her bizarre rituals and ends up in the afterlife's waiting room. There, she tries to summon Beetlejuice for help, unaware of her new ghostly state. The climax occurs at Lydia's wedding, where Rory's true intentions are revealed. He only wants to marry Lydia for her money. Beetlejuice attempts to push forward with his own marriage to Lydia, trapping the wedding guests in their phones. But this is interrupted by Dolores. Astrid uses the handbook of the recently deceased to summon the sandworm, which devours Dolores and Rory. Wedding plans are thwarted when Astrid finds a loophole that nullifies the marriage contract, as Lydia is still alive. Lydia says Beetlejuice's name 3 times, causing him to explode. Afterward, Delia accepts her fate as a ghost, saying goodbye to Lydia and Astrid before reuniting with Charles in the afterlife. With the chaos behind them, Lydia decides to retire from her show to spend more time with Astrid. In a humorous final twist, Lydia has a nightmare about Astrid marrying a Dracula-like boy and giving birth to a monstrous Beetlejuice baby, only to wake up and find Beetlejuice next to her. Another nightmare within a nightmare, showing she is not free of him yet. Make sure to subscribe for more recaps like this.